What is the most fucked up thing that happened in a children's TV show? Too many episodes of Hey Arnold. Like finding out Stoop Kid stayed on his stoop because he was abandoned there and was homeless, but hopelessly waiting for someone to come back for him. How Monkey Man was mentally ill and also homeless. That one where you learn Grandpa and his sister had a lifelong rift because the only good thing in their life as children, their puppy, got killed by a car in front of them, and they each blamed the other. How Lilla and her dad ask Waters to keep from being homeless. How the kids on the show routinely get mugged, or how Mr. Hyan hates Christmas because that's the anniversary of the day he handed his baby daughter off to an American soldier to get her out of the war zone because he wasn't sure they'd survive, then spent the rest of his life working to immigrate to America to try and find her only having the name of the city to work from, and ended up missing her whole childhood because he was too poor to hire a private investigator. Until Helga literally sold the shoes off her feet to hire one to make Arnold happy. Oh, and how Helga is obsessed with Arnold because she grew up neglected by an alcoholic mother and aggressive narcissistic father who only cared about her older sister, and Arnold was literally the first person in her entire life to show her any kindness when, as a preschooler, he offered to share his umbrella because her parents forgot to take her to her first day of preschool and she had to walk in the rain by herself with no coat as a 4-year-old in what we can only assume is New York City. So yeah, that show was supremely jacked up. Hey Arnold was one of those shows that got real in not just plot but emotional consequences. It even got us to relate to the rich kid Lorenzo in how isolating and emotionally empty a privileged life can be. It never shied away from real world things like poverty, trauma, corrupt politics, Mr. Green's run for mayor, or anything that parents tend to hide from the 10 years olds watching it. I remember that episode of the Magic School Bus, when that ginger dude took off his helmet in space, after being told not to and his dome turned to ice or something like that. Spooked me as a kid. There was a story from Chicago's golden age of children's television, at WGN in the 1950s. A chimpanzee was the sidekick to a host, and would do interstitials to Three Stooges shorts. One time they had a guest who had a parakeet that could perform various tricks. Here's the quote from the book. The bird, perched on the woman's hand, went through a series of routines as Grayson, the host, and Chatter, the chimpanzee, looked on. In the middle of the act, Chatter suddenly grabbed the bird, bit its head off, and, without missing a beat, placed the carcass back on the shocked woman's hand. As his guest crumpled to the floor, a stunned Grayson stared at his partner and the station cut quickly to a commercial. We'll be right back. Remember when SpongeBob and Mr. Krabs murdered and buried the health inspector? This was a great episode though. Like most of Courage the Cowardly Dog. Return the slab. For us in the UK, The Animals of Farthing Wood, graphic gruesome death was a regular feature. http://tv/a778928/6-most-traumatic-moments-in-animals-of-farthing-wood/ It included. Mr. and Mrs. Hedgehog getting run over. Whatever you do, dearest, don't curl up, squish. Mr. Pheasant is shot dead as he stares in horror at his dead wife, shot earlier, who has been cooked and roasted. Sinuous the adder is choked to death by rats. The baby mice are impaled on thorns by a shrike. There were 24 deaths across 39 episodes. Every one of them a major character. I used to watch Animals of Farthing Wood at 6:25 a.m. every single weekday morning before school. I kept hoping they would finally reach White Deer Park, and it would be happy and good, but oh no. White Deer Park was just the beginning. There's this Hey Arnold episode called The Ghost Bride, and the story is basically that this lady was madly in love with her fiancé, but was stood up at the altar because he had fallen in love with her sister and married her the very next day. So the lady goes berserk and puts on her wedding dress, gets snacks from her basement, walks to the newlywed couple's home, kills them both in their beds, and when the cops come, she's rocking back and forth in a rocking chair next to the bodies, throwing rice on them, and humming the wedding march. To finish it all off, she immediately jumps out of the window and kills herself. I'm starting to wonder if I ever watched Hey Arnold at all. Not exactly on the children's show itself, but about 20 years ago during a midday episode of the Spider-Man cartoon, the news broke in to cover a live high-speed chase that ended in a standoff on a popular Los Angeles freeway. The suspect abruptly blew the top of his own head off with a rifle on live television. The top of his head literally flapped open like a can of spaghetti OS. Camera caught everything, I assure you. Kids watching that were never the same. Man, I remember that. I was in high school at the time, and learned about the incident from a Time magazine in the school library, while I was doing a project on current events. There was a very special anti-drug episode of the 80s cartoon Brave Stare. In this episode, a couple of kids get hooked on a new drug. At the end of the episode, one of the kids died from an overdose 30 plus years later, and I'm not sure how many children's shows even today would kill a kid. Captain Planet did the same thing. A drug called Bliss, that makes the user happy and all their problems go away, but also makes them reckless, and not fear injury or death, and is extremely addictive. Linka's cousin gets addicted, and then manages to get hooked, but she quits, after he dies of an overdose. Either the series finale of ALF, in which ALF is captured by the government presumably to be experimented on, or the series finale of Dinosaurs, in which the entire civilization is destroyed. I was about to post the Dinosaurs one. The finale was them just staring out the window at snow, and while I don't think they knew what was going to happen, we sure as fuck did. That episode of Thomas the Tank Engine, when Thomas visits the scrap heap where all the dead slash dying trains are. I remember watching it as a kid, and not even thinking about how Thomas is basically surrounded by a bunch of corpses or people left to die. There's a whole song number in the Brave Little Toaster of cars in a scrapyard accepting imminent death and a few committing suicide. Not really as messed up as ALBIS, but still creepy. That episode of Tom and Jerry, where Tom gets depressed, and sits on a railroad track, waiting for a train to come. Then Jerry comes to join him sitting down. The episode cuts to black and ends, and it never mentions it after that. Strange. Speaking from personal experience, it was when the Watergate hearings replaced my usual after school helping of Batman. And it went on for months. Henry the Tank Engine was bricked up inside an abandoned tunnel for having anxiety, while Ringo Starr mocked him. Not the worst fate in the railway series, one of the narrow gauge engines was turned into a stationary generator. Suppy sales in 1965. New Year's Day incident. Edit. On January 1st, 1965, miffed at having to work on the holiday, sales ended his live broadcast by encouraging his young viewers to tiptoe into their still sleeping parents' bedrooms and remove those funny green pieces of paper with pictures of US presidents from their pants and pocketbooks. Put them in an envelope and mail them to me, Suppy instructed the children. 12. Several days later, substantial amounts of money had begun arriving in the mail. Sales stated that the total amount received was in the thousands of dollars, but qualified that by stating that much of that was in play money. 13. Sales said he had been joking and that whatever real money had been sent would be donated to charity, but as parents' complaints increased, WNEW's management suspended sales for 2 weeks. 14. This perfectly illustrates an important lesson for all businesses out there. Don't fuck around the people you hire to be creative. As a child, I remember being fairly traumatized over a series called David the Gnome, where he and his wife reach 400 and die together in the finale. They actually become cherry trees intertwined together in the next plane. I remember trying to explain to my mother why I was crying so hard watching the TV, but she didn't get it. I can't believe I scrolled so long to find this. I bawled as a child watching this. I vividly recall them waving goodbye to Swift the Fox as they turn into trees. Edit. I found the clip and my childhood waterworks started at about 2 minutes. Looks like you slash Melissa Burr was correct and the Swift finds a female fox to run off with, but that howl is haunting. There was an episode of SpongeBob where Squidward got brain damage and thought he was a baby. Then the rest of the episode is just SpongeBob and Patrick throwing him about and shit. New SpongeBob is just plain sadistic at times. Some dude in SpongeBob literally shoved a coin up a horse's ass. I can't find the coin slot. Here it is. Comedy gold. Movie rather than TV show. But if I think of, that's really dark for kids. My mind always jumps to Clayton's death at the end of Tarzan. Dude accidentally hanging himself with a vine is pretty dark. I mean, Clayton was also basically an allegory for slavery and genocide with his obsession with killing rare specimens and the way he caged up all Tarzan's family, and put them on boats, to be shipped back to England. So yeah, dark end to a dark story. A few years ago, don't remember the year, New Jersey accidentally played hardcore porn in the time slot for a children's TV show. They played Mandy Gets a Handy instead of Handy Manny. It's New Jersey. This was not an accident. I think that Lemon grab from Adventure Time was pretty messed up, but especially when he swallowed the other Lemon grab after he broke his toy. The other Lemon grab screaming in terror as he was being swallowed always got to me when I was a kid, and it still gets to me now. You are talking specifically about this moment, about 10 seconds in the horror show begins. There is an episode of Scooby-Doo, one of the ones with Scooby, Shaggy and Scrappy only, where they are being chased around a pyramid by a mummy and they beat him by unraveling him, but then when they are leaving they turn round and footsteps are following them in the sand. They run away, footsteps return to the pyramid, and then the episode ends. Only example in classic Scooby I think where the monster was real. Fair to say I've been scared of mummies ever since, I'm in my 20s. Honestly, one of my favorite things about the movies was that the monster was always real. Man, that Cajun Cat People one was insane. That one episode of Pingu where he has a nightmare. In the nightmare, a gigantic brown seal chases him while smiling creepily. This episode still gives me the spooks to this day. Azula going insane at the end of Avatar scared me a lot as a kid. Plus the whole bloodbending episode is really really dark the more you think about it. SpongeBob, two complete strangers pretending to be Patrick's parents. Who were they? Why did they do it? What was their plan? Things I've been thinking about since I was 7 years old. Also every episode of Courage the Cowardly Dog. It's implied they were fucking stupid and thought they had a son, but they didn't actually have one. The only thing this doesn't explain is why they arrive on the same day his actual parents do. That episode of Teen Titans, where we learn about Raven's prophecy, has some very rappy undertones to it. Yeah, he just steadily burned more and more of her clothes off. Paraphrased, no matter how you fight or scream, there is nothing you can do to stop it. Oh, and there was that whole porn version. Megatron executing Ironhide by shooting him in the head point blank as he crawled along the floor in Transformers the movie in 1986. Eater, thanks for the silver award, and 1k likes. All of DFDM was pretty much a WTF thing. Kids had gone through two seasons of the show with these guys, and established media had made the Autobots pretty much invincible. There was an entire episode where Prime is dismembered, for Christ's sakes. And then all of a sudden the movie comes along, and kills off a one-third of the cast in the opening act. Ike. It pissed parents off, who wrote and called to Hasbro in droves. This ultimately led to the decision to air the G.I. Joe movie as a television film, and to save Duke was originally slated to die. The decision to bring Prime back to the cartoon was made in 87, but only 5 episodes featuring Prime would air before the American conclusion of the series. Probably either the reveal of the Air Nomad's genocide in Avatar or Bill Cipher's introductory scene, where he yanks a deer's teeth out of its head as a present in Gravity Falls. I actually think that's the most mundane thing Bill has done, just saying. It was pretty fucked up when Invader Zim had a plan to harvest the organs of children to make himself seem human. At the end, Zim was an enormous mass of stolen organs, while other kids were walking around with soda cans instead of lungs. Great show. Doip, my squeedless pooch. In the original Powerpuff Girls there was this episode called Buttercrush that I never really forgot. Buttercup sort of got into a relationship with the leader of the Gangrene Gang, but the leader kept on taking advantage of her, and she had no idea. It gets to the point where she ditches her sisters to hang out with him, but he just keeps on using her. Of course at the end she realized what was going on and beat him up, though. I guess it really wasn't that dark or anything, but it always made me feel sick inside when I saw it. Maybe it was partly about age difference, but it was the first time I saw a relationship like that in a cartoon. That sounds less like an issue with the age gap, and more about the fact that it is written like a straight-up abusive relationship, and showing the signs to look out for. The episode of Hey Arnold, where we learn about the Vietnam War and the fall of Saigon, and how this one guy had to give up his daughter. Very traumatic watching as a little kid. http://www.google.com/amp/s/nextshark.com/hey-arnold-christmas/amp/. The saddest one for me was when the popular girl goes home from school and her dad is crying because he ate the last can of food they had, and she is trying to comfort him. The Looney Tunes, where the bulldog, I think his name is Cesar or Omir, anyway, he wants to keep a kitten, his owner is already mad, so he tried to hide kitten, stuff happens, and he ends up believing the kitten was baked into cookies, and the owner gives him a cat-shaped cookie and has crying puddles of tears and grabs the cookie pretending it's the kitty, completely traumatized. Happy ending though, I remember that episode well. It nuzzled a little bed onto his fur, 10/10 made up for the realistic trauma. Nobody's mentioned the show Are You Afraid of the Dark? That shit was the most psychologically damaging show I ever watched as a child. The one that has haunted me to this day was an episode in which one way or another a young boy gets locked up in a jail cell and gets left behind in the freaking dark. That's how the episode ends, with him shouting and crying in the dark. Some Franz Kafka shit right there. Holy shit, yes, I loved it, but a bunch of those episodes gave me nightmares. Probably also the biggest reason I'm such a fan of horror and dread is artistic concepts. When Big Bird asked Stevie Wonder to come take a look at this. It's actually pretty normal to use those phrases with blind people. Well, the premise to Avatar The Last Airbender is a literal genocide of the protagonist's entire people. Korra was really fucked up. A whole ass terrorist attack at a professional sports arena was too damn real. Also, Korra getting her bending taken away from Ammon was really, really creepy. The dark lighting slash setting, the forcing her against her will, and her reaction afterwards made it feel like more than taking her bending away. If cartoons are allowed, then just watch Ren and Stimpy. The whole show is one massive fever dream. John K is fucked up in real life. Guy was dating teenagers in his 40s and shit. Ren and Stimpy is pure manic depressive. It. The Dark Crystal, full of complete nightmare fuel. I can only assume it got a G rating is because someone said, oh, look, it's Henson and his puppet things. That must be for kids. The astronomer slash witch slash guru getting burnt to death. The noise the skexes make. The giant cockroach army. It's not for kids.